10 more Southern California rap albums. First one we're going to look at here is Gorilla City by Gorilla Black. Gorilla Black was a rapper from Compton, and I believe this was his debut album on Virgin Records in 2004. And look at that, executive producer Jimmy Henchman, he's one of them. But you got Jazzy Faye, Nate Dogg, Alex Thomas, Mario Winans, Beanie Man. So definitely some R&B flavor on here. His whole thing was that he sounded quite a bit like Biggie, but was coming from a West Coast perspective. And I haven't listened to this album in a very long time. I thought it was okay, nothing special. But I think I'm gonna put that to the side and play it in the car sometime this week. Another Daz album, I Got Love in These Streets. Gangsta Advisory Records, also 2004. My favorite song on here is definitely It Feels Good to Be from the West Coast. WC, Ghetto Heisman. This was the one following The Shadiest One, one of my favorite hip-hop albums ever. And he signed a Def Jam for this, and it came out in 2002. Great album, but nothing, it doesn't compare even close to The Shadiest One. He's put out some stuff since then, this album called Return of the Barracuda. And I think he did a split album with Daz, and there were some pretty good ones on there. But I feel like the single on here was The Streets with Snoop and Nate Dogg. So Hard with Scarface is a good one. And the last song on here is Something to Live For. It's definitely a story with a pretty brutal ending, and not very pleasant, but definitely an impacting song for sure with a message. I do not have the second West Side Connection album. I think it was called Terrorist Threats. That was a solid album, but Bow Down, that was the one. Straight Off the Streets of Compton by Eazy-E. Ruthless Records, 1996. I think this came out right after Eazy-E died. I don't think this album is great. Not a lot of stand-up songs, but I'm going to go with Sippin' on a 40, Just to Let You Know. And I think it's the last song, Eternally. It's just kind of a beat with DJ Yella talking and reminiscing about life with Eazy, but I thought that was pretty nice. DJ Quick, Balance and Options. This was 2000 on Arista. I feel like this album actually got pretty lukewarm reception when it came out, but I think it's another classic for DJ Quick. Change the Game, Pitch In on a Party, I Don't Want to Party with You, Roger's Groove, one of those DJ Quick instrumentals, Do I Love Her, Speak On It. You got El DeBarge on here, just like the classic days of that's not El DeBarge, that is James DeBarge. Eric Sermon's on here, Sugar Free. I'm gonna give this one a 4.25 out of 5. Almost forgot about this one. All From the Eye. Eye is in Inglewood. This was a group on Mac 10's Who Bangin' Records. Well, actually, this was on Priority. And then they would sign with Mac 10 later. But this was a group discovered by Mac 10. and that's Squeak Roo, who would have a, they did both have solo careers, but you have Binky Mac, who would more so work with Mac 10, and then Squeak Roo, who did his own thing. But I like Who Ridin', the Posse song near the beginning, Fill My Cup, and Dopest on the Planet with Mac 10 and Ice Cube. If I didn't mention, I is Inglewood, same city as Mac 10. Dr. Dre, The Chronic, the first Dr. Dre solo album following his departure from Death Row. Classic album, but just like 2001, I gotta say that there's definitely a couple songs that I skip every time. With Dre Day, you gotta love it. Let Me Ride, Nothing But a G Thing. We all know this stuff, but again, I think 2/3 is amazing, 1/3's okay. Could do without the skits, but I always feel that way about albums. Slight detour. A friend back in high school, he had this VHS tape. It was called Death Row Uncut. And it just had music videos, behind-the-scenes stuff. They had kind of a, overarching story with just some guys riding around in a car for the day. But I thought that was a pretty cool release. They even had some non-Death Row rappers, such as DJ Quick on there. He's doing a live performance of Dollars and Cents on there. But that was a great tape, and I wish I could get a copy of that on DVD. Maybe I can. Okay, I'm going to end this with a couple cheating releases. One is Novocaine by The Outlaws. The Outlaws are not from California, despite their close relation and their claim to fame being their relation with Tupac. And over the years, up until I think the present day, the Outlaws membership has changed. People going in and out. Fatal's passed away. Gaddafi's passed away. I think I'm missing at least one other person. But on this time, you have Edie, Napoleon, Castro, and Young Noble. And my favorite song on here has got to be Rise featuring Big Syke. They all tear it up on that one. Especially Big Syke. One more, let me think. Red Bull and Vodka, I kind of like that one too. Another Body Count album, and the last one I'm going to look at. This is Violent Demise, The Last Days. And when this came out, I loved it, and I thought it was the best Body Count album. Time has proven the debut self-titled to be the best one, but I think this one's still great. The standouts are My Way, Root of All Evil, and You're Fucking with BC. I remember, when I was like 14 and this came out, I remember I had in the Discman for some long school trip. I was living in Langley, BC, and we went to, Kelowna, Kamloops, somewhere. Don't remember where I went, but I remember what I was listening to, and it was definitely this. And finally, The Jacka. This is The Tonight Show, presented by DJ Fresh. So this doesn't really belong here because it's more of a Bay Area album. The Jacka is from Pittsburgh, California. But I forgot to put that in there, and I do want to address this. Jacka has passed away. Seems like it was a unfortunate accident that happened. If you didn't know, DJ Fresh, he did a lot of Bay Area mixtapes, like official mixtapes that were released for sale. And this was his with the Jacka. And my favorite one is probably Better Than All the Rest. They use that sample from You Got It All by the Jets, which is a old corny pop song, but I still kind of like it. And that's it. Got one more, maybe two of these left. Thanks for watching.